You're listening to the audio production of The Virtuous Circle by Gaby Natale, translated by Jaliman Vidal, published by HarperCollins Leadership and read by the author. Please note that you may download an accompanying PDF that provides enhanced materials for this audiobook. To download the PDF, please visit harperfocusaudio.com.
Dedication to Andy, my great love and companion on life's adventures for 15 years. Every turn in the virtuous circle is more beautiful because I turn hand in hand with you. To Roberto, Cristina, Alejandro, and Francisco, for giving me the foundations that allowed me to dream. To rebel dreamers who dare to see beyond the visible. Letter to the reader. Dear underdog, this book is my love letter to you. I see you. I see you working twice as hard to get half as far. I see you do more with less. I see you, the one people do not expect to win. I know you. I know you take a deep breath before entering a room where your individuality is met by a sea of sameness. I know you outwork the rest in hopes that over-delivering will protect you from other people's prejudice. I know you're tired of pushing yourself to prove your worth to skeptics. I celebrate you. I celebrate your refusal to trade authenticity for acceptance. I celebrate your courage in the face of adversity. I celebrate your appetite to be what you cannot yet see in the world. Your life is not an apology. This book is the story of an underdog who became obsessed with interviewing fellow underdogs to create a roadmap that can help others around the world in the pursuit of their dreams. The virtuous circle is also the result of my frustration when I could not find books on personal growth written by people like me. As a Latina who happens to be an immigrant, every time I saw myself represented in media, I felt I was reduced to a stereotype. Tired of seeing how others did an awful job at portraying my rich and multidimensional heritage, I decided it was time to write my own story. Today, I am proud to say I am the first Latina author published by HarperCollins Leadership. So how do leadership and self-help look if you are an underdog? You, my friend, are about to find out. The Virtuous Circle is here to tell you that there is beauty in being an underdog, to remind you that you do not need to change yourself to feel worthy, and that wonderful things can happen even in difficult times. The world has changed. The self-help space, not so much. I have always had an ambivalent relationship with a self-help world. Personal growth books have always been there for me every time life throws a curveball. But lately, I am seeing some trends in the self-help space that are genuinely concerning. Way too often, I find myself let down by so-called leaders who do not embody the principles they claim to teach. Some brag about possessions, relationships, or credentials that were not true to begin with. Others profited from an image that turned out to be false. A few claim to be self-made, but in reality came from money or married into it. As someone who is both an author and a reader in this space, I find the lack of accountability frustrating. There are plenty of people who talk the talk. Not that many have the commitment to walk the walk. As of lately, I cannot shake the feeling that the self-help industry is becoming unrelatable. Not all forms of optimism come from the same place. There is a kind of optimism that is part of the toolkit that some of us need to develop to overcome adversity. Things will work out, I know it, because this is not my first rodeo. This is the kind of optimism that moves me to the core. There is another kind of optimism that is quite different. It comes from not having to endure the same hardships others must face. Things will work out, I know it, because they have always worked out for me. The first kind of optimism comes from resilience. The second kind comes from privilege. Behind every Instagram post that claims, "Just do it, only you control your life," lies the illusion of a level playing field. Refusing to acknowledge that generational poverty, racial inequality, or nepotism play a role in the journey to accomplishment is the very definition of privilege. Only those who were never affected by systemic inequalities can pretend they do not exist. No. Everything is not just a matter of personal responsibility. There is something cruel about making people feel inadequate for life circumstances they did not choose. It sends the dangerous message that if you did not make it, it was only because you did not want it badly enough. Any underdog knows that reality is much more complicated. That is why advice coming from privileged optimism sounds tone-deaf to so many of us. Building a positive mindset and addressing negative self-talk are important, but they are only one part of the equation. The virtuous circle, from individual achievement to collective well-being. Here's a message to anyone who wants to make an impact in the world. The goal should not be to only make the best of the cards life has dealt you. The goal should also be to use your achievements for something greater than yourself. Let us all contribute to changing the rules. This is one of the reasons why the virtuous circle goes beyond individual goal setting. It aims for collective well-being. If there's anything to be learned from the economic, sanitary, environmental, and spiritual crises we've faced, is that ourselves, our well-being, and our future are inextricably linked to the rest of our fellow human beings. Making it big, but alone, does not solve the problems we have in front of us. Love, Gaby. Preface. The Virtuous Circle is a book for dreamers, the rebels at heart who see beyond the circumstances surrounding them. Those who suspect that something wonderful is waiting for them, but have not yet dared to take that first step toward their new destination. Why is it that some people who seem to have it all never reach their full potential, while others, born into adversity, beat the odds and become the highest, truest versions of themselves? This is the question that led me to write The Virtuous Circle after 10 years of interviews with pioneers and superachievers from different disciplines. Here, you will find tools for self-improvement as well as personal stories and testimonies from international trailblazers such as Deepak Chopra and Carlos Santana. Their stories reveal the amazing power of enthusiasm when it comes to transforming lives. Do you feel like there's a treasure inside you? Are you tired of your fears preventing you from spreading your wings and sharing that treasure with the world? Stop running around in circles and get on the virtuous circle. Introduction, Making Peace with Uncertainty. This book began with a small act of bravery that was rewarded by the universe. The Virtuous Circle is the result of an incredible chain of events that unleashed a domino effect. Events that can be explained only as the work of destiny. The first domino fell on a rainy winter night. It came in the form of a revelation. Every December, I like to do an exercise. I close my eyes, reflect on the year that is ending, and visualize the one about to begin. I think about what I can do to make the new year better than the last one. This practice gives me more clarity about what I have experienced and reminds me that I have before me a blank slate on which I can rewrite my story. As a communicator, I have interviewed hundreds of people, and I know from experience that the best conversations occur when my guests forget the cameras and speak with an open heart. No posing, no scripts, just brutal honesty. That was exactly how I spoke to myself that day. As I reflected, I discovered something I didn't like. I realized that in the previous 365 days, I had not left my comfort zone. I had, more or less, played it safe. It became clear to me that to continue growing in the following year, I needed to give myself permission to take more risks, to move beyond the known. I needed to do something scary. I had to abandon the role of only asking questions and start finding my own answers. I needed to share my story. Tick! The first domino had fallen, and without knowing it, I was already writing a new chapter of my life. The days passed, and the usual December marathon began. My mother-in-law, Marta, and my brother Francisco visited. Together, we planned a festive menu of homemade pasta, and then we enjoyed all the celebrations of the season. For a few days, I had almost no opportunity to reflect on my revelation. But on December 21st, an email arrived that would test me. Buried among all the end-of-year messages, it announced that this was the last day to enter a contest organized by YouTube called Storytellers. The rules were simple. You had to send in a 2-minute video telling a story from your life. The organizers would select 5 stories, and the winners would have the opportunity to share them in front of a live audience at a conference in Los Angeles. One more detail caught my attention. The name of the conference was suggestive. We All Grow. That was just what I had proposed to do the following year. Could it be a coincidence? A voice deep inside told me to set aside my doubts and enter the contest. Like an annoying gadfly, it persisted in telling me again and again how great an idea this was. You have wanted to face a challenge for some time, Gaby. This is an opportunity to experience something new. This will not be like when you do an interview on the show or host an event. Here, there is no preset script or theme of the day. There is no right or wrong content. It's about the story of your life. While this voice of enthusiasm tried to seduce me, my mind flooded with 1,000 reasons why I shouldn't do it. How ridiculous, Gaby! Why would a professional journalist share stories about her life that could potentially embarrass her? What could you possibly gain from participating in a contest that isn't even about journalism? What is this business of getting on a stage to talk about my life? If you get nervous and do it wrong, you'll look like a beginner. In 5 minutes, you'll destroy a reputation that took years to build. And then you'll really have a story to tell. I spent all day being pulled back and forth between the voices of enthusiasm and fear, which spoke to me in stereo. That night, my husband Andy and I had dinner reservations to celebrate the 14th anniversary of our first kiss. At 7:30, when I went downstairs to go out, I realized that it was now.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.